Hey there, welcome to the Getting Started with Trickest video. In this video, I'll walk you through the most important features of the platform and help you run your first workflow. So let's get started. The first page you'll see after you sign into the platform is the Spaces dashboard, where you can structure and organize your workflows into different folders. You can divide your workflows by function, like a space for recon and asset discovery workflows, another for vulnerability scanning, etc. Or if you work with multiple clients, you might want to create a new folder for each one of them or any other structure that works for you. Now let's hop into this pre-installed space, Playground, and take a look at this workflow, Simple Content Discovery. You can see its description right here below the title, along with some other useful high-level info. This workflow will enumerate subdomains, resolve them, and discover web content through a few different ways. Let's open this workflow and jump into the workflow editor, where the magic happens. We're currently in builder mode, where we can build and edit workflows. We use two popular subdomain enumeration tools here, Amass and Subfinder, and pass the target domain to the domain parameter of each tool. We can replace this placeholder with our actual target domain by clicking on the node and entering the domain right here. Amass and Subfinder will produce two separate output files. A good way to merge them into one nice file and remove duplicates is by using a shell script like this one here. The next node ahead is HTTP probe, which is going to resolve all of our subdomains and discover any live web servers. Then we pass the enumerated web servers to these three tools, which will perform content discovery in three different ways. Dir search is a directory brute forcer, hack crawler is a web crawler, and gao is a passive URL enumeration tool. In the end, we use the same shell script to merge the found URLs and remove duplicates so that we can have one nice output file with the merged results of all three tools. Now that we're ready to run the workflow, let's go ahead and click on this play button, save the workflow, and choose the set of machines we want to use. I won't go into too much detail about this now, but one quick tip. If you assign more than one machine to a workflow, then the platform will try to run your tools and scripts in parallel whenever possible to make the overall workflow faster. Like in our example here, Subfinder and Amass do not depend on each other's outputs, so they can run in parallel. And same goes for these three tools here, Dir Search, Hack Crawler, and Gao. You can learn more about how machines work in our product documentation. We are now in the Runs tab. As you can see, the run is now pending, which means that the platform is spinning up the machines needed to run the workflow, and it will start shortly. Our workflow is now running, and one step is already done. If we click on this node, we can see more info about it in these tabs down here. The Command tab shows the command we set while editing the workflow. The Standard Out tab shows the output you'd see if you ran the tool in a terminal. This is useful for following the progress of a tool. And the Standard Error tab will light up only if the tool runs into a problem and display the errors that we can use to fix it. Finally, and most importantly, the Output tab is where you'll find the output of the tool and you can go ahead and download it. While the workflow is running, now is a good time to take a step back and think about how we can make this workflow better. So let's put our builder hat back on and think. One quick win we can get here is passing API keys to Amass and Subfinder through their config parameters to let them query more data sources, which we can do by selecting each node, searching for the config parameter, turning it on, and same thing for Amass. And now we can connect these file inputs to these two tools, which we can do by clicking on the node, pasting the URL here, or uploading the file. We can also think about adding more tools. Let's search the library and see what other subdomain enumeration tools are out there. PureDNS is a really good one for active subdomain enumeration. We can configure it real quick here by connecting the domain, selecting brute force mode, and uploading some resolvers, some trusted resolvers, and a nice word list. And it's not just about subdomain enumeration. There are so many ways to further enrich and improve the data we got here. We can pass the found subdomains to a port scanner like Nabu. Nuclei for vulnerability scanning, Web Analyze for tech fingerprinting, Go Witness for screenshots. We can filter the found URLs using URL dedupe and GF, or any of the hundreds of other possible things we can do to make this workflow even more useful depending on what we're gonna use it for. Feel free to browse around the library for inspiration. Now let's check up on how our original workflow is doing by going back to the Runs tab. And hey, it's already completed. Every node is executed successfully, so we can go ahead, select the last node, and download the final output. And now our work is done here with this workflow, which means that we have time to close the editor and hop into the library where we can browse the pre-built workflow templates. We can select any workflow from here, take a quick look at it, and copy it to our space. Now we're ready to open the editor again and start automating one more thing.